Hi everyone, welcome back to DYOR. Today we will show you how to replace the Taptic Engine on the iPhone 13. Before starting, we need the right tools to proceed with the repair, which are listed in the description. First, turn off the phone and remove the SIM tray, and then undo two bottom screws by using pentalobe screwdriver. To take out the screen, first apply heat to soften the glue on the screen. For this, we are using a heating pad. Place the front screen side on the heating pad and select the mobile phone heating option. Leave it till the process completes. Alternatively, you can use a heat gun or hair dryer. And then, to lift the screen, need a suitable suction cup or something similar. In this guide, we are using a regular suction cup to lift the front assembly. Use the suction cup at the bottom to raise the screen. Gently pull the screen to create a gap, and then insert a plastic car pry tool or triangle picker. Next, work around the screen to free up the rubber gaskets on the frame. This process will take time, and be gentle with the screen. Once the screen is free, open the screen to a 90 degree angle from the right to the left. Next, undo three screws to take out the shield at the center. And four screws to take out the shield at the top. While pulling out shields, be gentle with the flex cables. Once the shields are free, first disconnect the battery plug and then follow with the LCD connector and earpiece assembly plugs from the logic board. Now can free the screen from the body. Next, remove the not working Taptic Engine from the body. First, take out the bracket by undoing two screws. Next, undo the screw securing the engine and disconnect the plug. And then gently pull out the unit from the body. Next, place the new Taptic Engine on the body and secure the plug and the screw. Next, secure the bracket by adding two screws. Next, add the pre-cut water seal adhesive into the frame. Please note that this tape will not completely protect the device against liquid. Next, place the front screen assembly on the body. First, connect the earpiece assembly plug and then the LCD connector plug. Finally, secure the battery plug to the logic board. Next, turn on the device for testing. And then secure both shields by adding screws. Next, locking the top section first. Then simultaneously click the sides and the bottom to clamp up the body and the screen. Just make sure to apply pressure on the frame sides. Next, secure the phone by adding two screws to the bottom. Hope you have enjoyed the replacement guide. Let us know if you have any questions. Please like, share and comment on our videos. Hit the subscribe button for more videos.